And so, I'm reviewing the MCU. All of it. Start to finish. I'm going through the series in chronological timeline order, not release order. Why? Because I felt like doing it that way, and it's fun. And you expect one of these every day or two, building up to the theatrical release of Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness. I may even throw a few quote-unquote non-canonical Marvel movies in there too, just for shits and giggles. Anyway, we'll see. Today, it's The Falcon and the Winter Soldier, the second Disney Plus series, a continuation of the Captain America saga, picking up story threads from Avengers Endgame as we see what has become of the title characters as they try to put their lives together after the, as they now call it, blip that has affected the world entire. Following the tradition of the Captain America movies, it is an action-packed, globe-trotting political thriller in an MCU context. It stars Anthony Mackie and Sebastian Stan as the title characters, and they are joined by Wyatt, son of Kurt, Russell, Erin Kellyman, Emily Van Camp, and Danielle Brühl. The series was directed by Carrie Skoglund. Let's take a look.
Kick your ass!
This is the most explicitly political thing the MCU has ever done, at least up until this point. Forget allegory, symbolism, subtext, it's all right there in the text. It continues the themes of accountability, of consequence, which have been the driving force of the MCU basically from the start. But then it deepens them, tying them specifically to American values and the cultural, socioeconomic realities of the United States, its relationship with its own citizens, and its place on the global stage. There is also meta-commentary here. That is to say, the reality of mainstream comic book heroism and the ever-present fear behind the scenes and amidst the conflictive audience of doing anything to challenge the status quo. Pretty deep, honestly, for what is at face value an old-school spy thriller, with the requisite thrills you've come to expect from the brand. There's plenty of action here, at least one major set piece or fight sequence every half hour or so. But there is also nuance, character growth, a wealth of human emotion. Really strong performances across the board. The leads are in fine form, of course, but you also get show-stealing bits from Danielle Brühl and the underused Carl Lumley, and you get nicely textured layered turns from Erin Kellyman and Wyatt Russell as antagonistic elements, who are not quite as black and white as you typically get from this sort of thing. I really appreciate that this goes there, exploring the complexities of character motivation and how even those we are quick to single out as villains are very likely the heroes of their own stories. I can forgive a couple of forays into the obvious and one plot twist that doesn't quite make sense, because the story on a whole is very well structured. It includes a good balance of blockbuster thrills and contemplative breathers, all of which build to a satisfying emotional payoff. It's really an excellent piece of work. Hey, I hope you liked this video, and if you did, please give me a like and subscribe to my channel and share the video. There's going to be some cool stuff coming to the channel, so you're going to want to keep track of it, and I hope you like all that stuff too. See ya.